bridge, one of the most traveled bridges in all of Pittsburgh tonight, we're being told it's in such bad shape, certain vehicles may soon be banned. That's if state lawmakers don't act quickly, passing a transportation bill. And Action News reporter Sheldon Ingram shows us how bad the bridge is getting.
PennDOT says Liberty Bridge has already started the first phase of deterioration. The first sign, heavy rust developing on the beams. And then if you take a look here, it's a pile of rust that's developed, that's already fallen off of the beams as well.
Can this ever happen to the Liberty Bridge? PennDOT says, sure it can. This is the I-35W bridge in Minneapolis that collapsed over the Mississippi River in 2007, killing 13 people. The Liberty Bridge is the same model, a steel truss. PennDOT says the only difference is that the Liberty Bridge isn't as far along in deterioration, but it's on its way.
People going across bridges and unbeknowingly dropping right into the river. I mean, sure, that's got to be scary for everybody.
PennDOT Supervisor Dan Cessna says it's very obvious to see where the bridge is eroding.
The biggest thing that jumps out would be the rusting steel.
Here's how PennDOT evaluates the condition of the Liberty Bridge. It's rated on a scale of 1 to 9, with 5 being the average mark. The Liberty Bridge has a rating of 4. If nothing is done in 2 years, weight limits will have to be enforced as it continues to rot. The cost to make it sturdy, $40 to $60 million.
The importance of a bridge like this one is a key bridge in our artery system of transportation.
Governor Tom Corbett is pressing state legislators to pass the transportation bill along with two other bills to allocate funding for the bridge repairs across the state. While he is confident the bills will be passed, the governor says they need to happen by June 30th for the new budget. Ultimately, without funding, weight limits will be posted, diverting heavy trucks and buses to other routes in the region, creating a traffic nightmare. And that's something neither the governor or legislators want to see happen. Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.
A plan just approved by the state Senate this week would boost state funding for transportation by 50% to $2.5 billion, but that bill faces uncertainty in the state House. We'll keep you updated on the progress there. And we also have the full list of deficient bridges statewide on WTAE.com. If you'd like to check on the ones you use the most, just click on the On TV tab at the top of our homepage. And Matt